Today I want to demonstrate how we can do more complex operation on a surface. So we start with this surface from one of the last videos, and I start the editor on it. Meantime, there are a lot of methods which I have to put into the dialog, so I have splitted the functionality in different tabs, and I can fill the tabs step by step. Okay, we hide this, we hide the map, we create for the face a B-grid to see a little bit of structure. And the first thing what we can do is we can select some special groups of this control point. So we can select Y line 3, and this is these are these points which belong to this meridian. And we also can select a U line, a rib, for example number 2. We can select U number 3. 3 is here on the top, and I use number 4. Number 4 is the end of the face here inside of our object. Here we can see it. We are inside the object. So, and now we want to do a transformation. The first thing what we can do, we can say we want to scale it from the center of mass, from the center of this selected points. This is this point here. We can activate it here. And now I go to extensions, and I have the possibility, for example, to scale it outside and inside. And to be exact, I use the command scale dot 8, scale by 20% inside. So we have this. We are have now this squeezed together, and the next thing what we want to do is we want to put it outside. So we use the Z coordinate and we lift it up, and then we apply it. So this is the new result. Let's see, the full face looks like this. Okay, the next step is that we want to use, instead of the center of mass, the reference point. A reference point is a point which does not depends on the face. The reference point is the top of this cone, so I can move this cone from here up somewhere here. And here I move it to this point. Okay, and here we see once more what we want to edit. And now we want to rotate the selected point around this center. Okay, now when I change here the Euler rotation, we see that the selected points are rotated around this point. And we can also use the other direction to get it rotated this way. So then we apply it, and we have the new result. And now we can compare this new result with the old one. Here we have the old mesh, here we have the new object, and we can see what are the difference between both. At the end, we want to save our result. At the moment, the result is in this temp multiface object, and if I change it, it is overwritten. So I can only say apply and close. And in this case, I have here the result object.